Hello, my name is Representative Pam Powers Hanley, and I represent LD9 in Tucson in the Arizona House. Well, today is February 3rd. It's a Monday. We had our Ways and Means Committee briefing this morning, and there's another four tax giveaway bills on the agenda for this coming Wednesday if you want to go look at the agenda and make some comments on request to speak. So today's video is about HB 2732. This is the affordable housing tax credit that has been killed a few years in a row. Now, the reason that we've been killing it is that it's a tax credit for affordable housing that increases every year over time. And in past years, it was up to like 100 million or so when it was at its full height, right? And so this one is a little bit more modest, but still it's at 80 million at the top. So what happens is this is capped at $8 million a year, but it goes up every year. So the first year it'll be $8 million, the second year it'll be $16 million, the third year it'll be $24 million, and keep going up. And so people get the credit for 10 years. So the guys who get it in 2021 will have it until 2031. And the guys who get it in 22 will have it into 32 and like that. So you can see at the top, it's going to be a lot of money. So the question is, in 10 years, are we going to be able to afford $80 million or so out of the general fund to do this? We don't know that. We don't know that. We also know, though, that giving tax breaks to developers is not the only way to have affordable housing. In fact, last year in committee, it was kind of ironic that the Institute for Justice actually spoke against this, because they were saying that by subsidizing somebody's rent, for example, you say, oh, teachers don't make enough, we should subsidize their rent and put them in a $1,000 a month apartment, but have them only pay $500. Well, that's just making it easier for them to live in poverty, right? Or live with low wages. Why don't we increase their wages and then they can afford the housing? The other thing that we could be doing is we could be fully funding the housing trust fund, because the housing trust fund gives the state a variety of ways to stimulate affordable housing or low-income housing or housing for the homeless. And so this is not the only way to do things. Giving tax breaks for developers is not the only way to build affordable housing. I also think developers are getting plenty of tax breaks with the opportunity zones that are coming online now. So I think that we should look at higher wages, and we should look at the housing trust fund and more imaginative ways to help people stay in their homes.